All right, good evening, everyone. Welcome, welcome to this evening's class. This evening, we'll be doing a deep dive into the Elliott Wave corrections. And for part one, we're going to be doing flat patterns. Okay? Please, guys, have a look at the unit of prosperity disclaimer. Be sure to read our disclaimer on our website. Be sure to look at the terms and conditions. Remember, we are not financial advisors. Everything we do here is strictly for educational purposes. Okay? All right, so just trying to give the others a chance to get on from the start. We have quite a few of you here right now. I know the others may want to catch the recording, so we're not going to wait too long for them. All right, so let's jump into it. Okay, so flat patterns. What is a flat pattern? I see some of you are still coming in. That's good, that's good. Welcome, welcome. All right, so flat patterns. What is a flat pattern? A flat pattern is a simple price correction. It also subdivides into three waves. Normally, these waves are marked as A, B, C. But in other cases, you could see them marked as W, X, Y. Okay? Now, the market is dynamic. I know that when it comes to corrective formations, they can evolve. Okay, so it's not always as straightforward as we may think. Traditionally, flat patterns came as ABC. But in today's world, you can see flat patterns come as WXY as well. All right, so the main rules for flats are flats consist of three waves. Okay, now how many of you are familiar with what a three-wave pattern is? Just let me know in the chat box. How many of you are familiar with what a three-wave pattern is? Just giving you guys a chance to send in your comment. How many of you are familiar with what a three-wave pattern is? I see Bella says, is a head and shoulders considered? No. A head and shoulder pattern is not considered a three-wave pattern, but a head and shoulder pattern could consist of a three-wave pattern inside of it. Okay, now, as we go along, we'll get into the head and shoulders pattern as well, okay? All right, so let's see here. Gary says, not me. Grace says, impulse correction continuation. Okay, okay. I think I can accept impulse correction continuation. So what Grace basically means is we get an impulse wave, we get a corrective wave, we get another impulse wave. That is more or less a zigzag, okay? It's more or less a zigzag pattern, ABC, all right? All right, Patrick says, not familiar. Bella says, triple top. No, 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 no. All right, okay. All right, guys, so a flat pattern, as I said, consists of three waves, and usually they're labeled as A, B, C. However, in today's world, we can also see them as W, X, Y. Now, as we go along, we will get into what a W, X, Y pattern is, what an A, B, C pattern is, and so on, okay? Now, wave A also could be wave W, could be any corrective pattern, except a triangle. Okay? Now, as we go deeper, we will understand where we can find triangles. But just to give you guys a little bit more information, we can always find triangles in a wave 2 or a wave 4, okay, of an impulse wave or a 3-wave corrective move, okay? Now, wave B could also be a X wave, could be any corrective pattern, but in most cases, it's a zigzag. So normally when you see a correction, the middle wave is normally a 3-wave move, which is generally a zigzag, which means we get 5 waves, 3 waves, 5 waves, okay? Almost shaped like a lightning bolt. Wave C also could be wave Y, is impulsive, but it can also be a corrective wave or an ending diagonal. Now, as we go along, we'll get more familiar with what a diagonal formation is, okay? A diagonal is similar to a triangle, okay? Now, wave B has a length of more than 90% of wave A. Wave C is usually equal or even longer than wave B, okay? So wave C, which is the third wave, or it could be labeled as wave Y, it could be equal to or longer than wave B, okay? Wave A and wave C are impulsive. Wave B is corrective. When I say corrective, I mean 3-wave pattern. When I say impulsive, I mean it's either an aggressive wave, very aggressive wave, or it's a 5-wave move. Okay, now we could have a 3-wave corrective impulsive wave, okay? Now, a corrective impulsive wave is generally the impulse of a correction, because corrections also have impulses, okay? Now, let's go a little deeper. Flat pattern variations. There are 3 types of flat patterns, depending on the length of wave B and wave C, that will determine which type of flat pattern we're looking at. A regular flat wave B is almost equal to wave A. Now, in a moment, I will show you guys what these flat patterns actually look like, okay? So remember, in a regular flat, wave B is almost equal to wave A. It's at least 90% of its length, while wave C tends to be equal to wave B, okay? Now that's a regular flat. That's where we don't have price breaking the high or breaking the low, okay? Like price basically just goes flat, just goes sideways. An expanded flat, wave B is longer than wave A, and wave C is longer than wave B, okay? A running flat, wave B is longer than wave A, but wave C is shorter than wave B. So let's take a look at what these flat patterns actually look like. All right, so here we have a regular flat. And this is basically what it looks like. This is a bullish example, and this is a bearish example, okay? Here you can see the price is coming from the downside, moving up, and you get 1, 2, 3. This is a 3-wave move down, then you get a 3-wave move up, then you get a 5-wave move down. Now, this five-wave move that you're looking at does not have to be five waves. It could also be a three-wave move like ABC, or it could be labeled WXY, okay? It all depends on how the waves are constructed. So as you can see here, flat patterns are made up of three waves down, if you're looking at an uptrend, three waves up, and five waves down. This wave C could also be three waves down, okay? But in a regular flat pattern, you can see here that the high, let me just annotate a little bit for you. Let's just look to draw on the screen. 1 second. Where is my annotate? Okay, that option is not enabled here. Let me see if I can find it or enable it. 1 second. Okay. All right, I can't find it. But the idea of wave B crossing the high that price created is what we're looking at. So wave B should not surpass the high that was created when we got wave A. So wave A in an uptrend, wave A is coming down against that uptrend. Okay, so we have wave A coming down. It's a pullback against the trend. Then we have wave B going in the direction of the trend without breaking the high. Okay, after wave B completes in three waves, we now will get wave C. Wave C can go down in five waves, or it can also come down in three waves without breaking the low of wave A. Okay? And that's what makes this a flat pattern formation. Here you can see in the bearish example, you have the trend coming down. This is now the low because price would bounce here, go back to the upside. With price pulling back, it's pulling back in three waves. After the three waves have completed, it's going to push down again in the direction of the trend. In this case, it does not break the low. Price goes back to the upside. It goes back to the upside in five waves, or as I said, it can go back to the upside in three waves without breaking the high. Okay, then price will continue in the direction of the trend. And this is a bearish flat pattern formation. Okay, as you can see, if you look at it, it is 1, 2, 3 waves. All right, any questions so far? I see Bella says bearish looks like a head and shoulders. No, it's not a head and shoulders formation. It may look similar right now, but this leg after the completion of the C wave is actually the continuation of the trend to the downside. So it would not be a head and shoulders formation because this one would not stop short and go back to the upside. Plus, there is the point that in a lot of cases, these lows may be equal to each other. Okay, and head and shoulders do not have equal lows or equal highs. Okay, this is more something that a lot of traders would look at and say it's a double bottom, or in this case, they could say this is a double top. Okay, I'm sure most of you guys are more familiar with double bottoms and double tops because they're more traditional patterns. Okay, I see Bella saying, okay, so I'm a little confused. Do flat patterns contain higher high and lower low? Okay. All right. So this is a high and this is a higher high. Okay. This is a low and this is a lower low. So price action on a whole contains higher highs and higher lows. Okay. But it does not mean that it's a head and shoulders formation. All right. Bella says, right. Thank you. You're most welcome. Okay. So let's look at the expanded flat formation. The expanded flat formation is a little bit different from the regular flat formation. They are constructed in the same wave construction in terms of, since this is a bullish move to the upside, we have three waves pullback, three waves in the direction of the trend, and then we have a five wave pullback or another three wave pullback. But in this case, after the move up in the direction of the trend, we get the pullback. After we get the pullback, the move that continues in the direction of the trend will break the high. Okay? So the move in the direction of the trend will break the high, but it will be in three waves. When the move completes, it's going to come back against the trend. And it will come back in five waves, or it will come back in three waves. And it will break the low. Okay? Generally, after it breaks the low, since this is an uptrend, price will move to the upside. Okay? The trend will continue up. Everything clear so far with the expanded flat? Just give me a hint in the. Okay, I see Kimberly says yes, everything's clear. Bella, what about you? We have Gary here, we have Jody, we have Joshua, we have Kimberly, we have Grace, Noble, Patrick, and many others. Let me know, guys. Are you guys clear so far? Is there anything that you're not too clear on? When I'm done explaining the flat patterns, we will go to the chart and we will try to identify some. All right. Wonderful, wonderful. Okay, so over here we have an example of a bearish expanded flat pattern. This move represents the trend. This is the direction that the price was coming down in. Now you have a three-wave pullback against that trend, followed by another three-wave move in the direction of the trend. The move against the trend is our A wave, or in some cases, we can consider it to be our W. Okay? The move in the direction of the trend is our B wave. In some cases, we could consider it to be our X wave. Okay? And the B wave or X wave will come in three waves. In some cases, it could be a triangle. Okay? Now, the C wave or the Y wave will generally go against the trend and will come in five waves, or it can come in three waves. Now, as I said, with the expanded flat, the trend low that was created will be broken by the C wave, sorry, by the B wave. Okay? When the B wave breaks the low of that was in the direction of the trend, the price will push back against the trend and it will break the high of the A wave. When the high of the A wave is broken, the price will come back to the downside. And that is how a expanded flat formation is constructed. We also have what we refer to as a running flat formation. Now, the running flat formation is a little bit different as well, but it's one of the variations of flat patterns. This is where, for example, since this is an uptrend, we have price moving up, we have price pulling back in a three-wave move, price pushing in the direction of the trend in a three-wave move. In this case, we have price breaking the high that the trend created, coming back to the downside in five waves or in three waves, but it does not break the low. So a running flat may break the high, but not break the low, or it may not break the high, but break the low. Okay? So with a running flat, only the high is broken or the low is broken. Okay? One or the other. In this case, we have a bearish setup. Price is coming down. It creates a low. It bounces back to the upside. It gives us a three-wave move. That three-wave move completes itself, pushes down again in another three-wave move in the direction of the trend. After the price breaks the low, it pushes back to the upside in another three-wave move or in a five-wave move before going back in the direction of the trend. So let's go to our chart. Now, I do have my chart here on the Euro-Dollar-US dollar pair, but if you guys would like me to look at any other pair, feel free. You can drop your comments in the chat box. Are you guys okay with me looking at the Euro-Dollar-US dollar pair, or is there a pair that you would prefer? Okay, I see Gary says EU is fine. I see Patrick says yes. Bella says it's fine. Okay, wonderful. Because I would like to show you guys this pretty much in real time. Okay? I'm not going to pick any special instrument. I'm just going to let you guys pick whichever one you want. Because I want you to understand that these patterns exist on all instruments. Every single one. Okay? So, who can help me to identify a flat pattern? Someone. Just pull up your chart, go to the 1 hour time frame on Euro dollar, US dollar, and just look at the current data that we have available to us from, let's see here, let's say from the 19th of April to today, and tell me if you see a flat pattern anywhere. Just let me know in the chat box if you think you see a flat pattern anywhere. I see Bella says, I see a regular flat. Bella, can you give me an idea of where you see this regular flat? And she said it's bearish. Okay. Where do you see this regular flat, Bella? Give me maybe a date where you think it started and I'll try to look for it. Just giving Bella a few seconds. Anyone else see a flat pattern? Bella says right by your 26. Okay. I see this is 26 over here. All right. Mm-hmm. Beloved, did I draw my line in the correct location? Is this the area that you're talking about? A little more to the left. Okay, so you said it's definitely under 26. Okay, all right. I think that's good enough, Bella. But this is how I like to outline a flat pattern. I like to use horizontal lines, okay? In some cases, my lines may be sloped, but I like to use horizontal lines because they give me a very good idea if I'm getting a flat, right? So let me use an arrow. This move would be the direction of the trend, okay? Because the flat pattern is happening here. So this would be the direction of the trend. And though this is a shorter term trend, this is still the trend. Now, how do we label flat patterns? We label them as ABC or WXY or ABCD. So I like using WXYs because the market is full of three-wave moves. So I just simply use WXY to label my waves, my three-wave moves, because really it doesn't matter that much. Once you can identify that the wave consists of three waves, that is the main part. You just need to make sure that you're looking at a three-wave move or you're looking at a five-wave move. A five-wave move is considered impulsive. A three-wave move is considered to be corrective. Okay? So here we have price pushing down. We have price pushing down here. This is an aggressive move. So I would consider this to be impulsive corrective because you can see that it's coming down aggressively. Okay? It's coming down aggressively. I would say this is 1, 2, 3 waves. All right. So I could label this. I can label this as ABC. I can label this like that and say this is ABC. Okay. Because we have three waves down. And now I'm going to use WXY for this one. You can see we have a W, that's one wave up. We have 1, 2, 3 waves down. This will make our X. And then we have 1, 2, 3 waves up. Okay, so this is an example of what I just showed you guys, where we can have a three wave move in the C wave or in the Y wave, okay? Because a flat pattern could be constructed using a WXY corrective formation. So here we have three waves going sideways. Can someone tell me what type of flat pattern this is? What type of flat pattern is this? Anyone? Okay, I see Bella says expanded flat. Okay, she's asking the question whether it's an expanded flat or not. Anyone else? Anyone else would like to give an opinion on what type of flat pattern you think this is? Giving you guys a few seconds. Anyone? There is no wrong, there is no right answer. There is only knowledge. Okay? So don't be afraid. Go ahead, drop your questions, drop your answers. I see Patrick says a regular flat. Kevin says not sure. Okay, those are okay answers. We can accept that. Bella says, I originally thought it was regular. Okay. All good answers. However, let's go back over here. A regular flat, wave B is almost equal to wave A, while wave C tends to be equal to wave B. Okay? And here you can see in a regular flat, we do not break the high and we do not break the low. In an expanded flat, we break the high and we also break the low. Okay? In a running flat, we break the high, but we don't break the low. The alternative to this would be we break the low, but we don't break the high. Okay, so I'll give you guys another chance. What type of flat pattern do you think this is? Give you guys one last chance. Okay, I see Kimberly says running flat. Bella says running flat. Who else? Anyone else? Who else would like to give an opinion? Patrick says running flat. Wonderful, wonderful. So you guys got it correct. This is a running flat. And why is it a running flat, guys? Why is this a running flat? Someone tell me. Why is this a running flat formation? Bella says because B is longer. Okay, so I have it labeled here as WXY, but it could also be labeled as ABC. Let me just remove that and let's put it in as A, B, and C. Okay. Okay, I see Bella was getting a little bit confused. It's okay, Bella. It's okay, don't be quiet. You can give your comments. There is no wrong answer. There is nothing such as a wrong answer. As I said, there is only knowledge. Okay, so we got to get things wrong so that you can learn. That's the only way that we learn. We learn from our mistakes. All right, especially in the trading world, we learn from our mistakes. So we learn the hard way. Okay, so don't be afraid. So here you can see that we have the move pushing down. We have the correction pushing up, creating this high. Now the price pushes down again. At this point, most of us are thinking that the price is going to fall, that the price is falling aggressively, maybe to create another wave like this, or it's just going to be falling off the chart. Okay? And what happens? It gets rejected at the low. When it gets rejected at the low, you can see here that it broke the low. And after breaking the low, it's pushed back to the upside. In this case, you can see it's pushing up in three waves. Now, traditionally, wave C would be expected to be five waves. But price patterns have evolved. And now you can see wave C in three waves. Not only in five waves, but in some cases, you will also see wave C in three waves. All right. So in this case, we have wave C coming in three waves. We have wave B also in three waves. And we have the A wave that looks very strong. Okay, but if we drop down to a lower time frame, I'm sure that we would be able to see that this A wave is also in three waves. Okay, let me just drop to the 15 minute, show you guys what I'm talking about. Here you can see wave C. It would be like, this would be your correction. Got like that. That would be your correction. And this would make it one, two, and this is three. Let me just change the color. Can you understand that? If I draw the lines in, just to mark this out, this would be the high. Let's change the color, let's put it in red. So that would be the high, and this would be the low, right? So on a lower time frame, if you look at price, you can see the same patterns repeating themselves. And you can also tell that this is also a flat pattern formation. This is a running flat formation. You have wave A coming down, wave B pushing up, breaking the high. And then you have wave C pushing down, does not break the low, goes back to the upside. Okay, and this makes a three-wave move. Now, I know this looks complex to some of you, but it's actually very simple, okay? Don't overcomplicate the situation. Just allow your mind to open and just accept it as it is, okay? Don't try to make too much out of it. So if I go back to the one-hour time frame, as you can see, it's not so visible anymore, okay? Because on the 1 hour time frame, the candles are compressed, okay? So the candles are compressed, so you don't see all of the price action that created those candles on the 1 hour time frame. So let me just clean this up a bit. All right. Put this back on. Can you guys identify the three wave moves in wave B and wave C? Are you guys able to see it? In the market, it's good to be able to visually identify the waves that you're looking at. It's not a case where you have to, you know, do too much measuring and trying to calculate. It's just visual. Just try to look at the price action and see what shapes it's making. That's what you need to focus on. Just focus on the shape of price action. Price action is made of geometric patterns, okay? So focus more on the shape of the price action. All right. So here you can see here that this is a running flat formation. We have price breaking the low, not breaking the high, then coming back to the downside. With the price coming back to the downside, what did it complete? It simply completed a bigger three-wave move. One, two, three. And I can change the color of this. Let's use this color. Let's make it a bit thicker. All right. So we simply just got a bigger three-wave move. Now, as we go along, if you go deeper into the Elliott wave theory, you will understand what a truncated wave is. And this is an example of a truncated wave. Okay? Now, if you look at this wave, right? If you look at that wave, let me see if I can look at this. Right, look at that. I'm taking that pattern and putting it out here, right? And look at this. Just gonna make this one a little smaller, okay? Just to kind of match the size. And let me see if I can spin this one around a bit. Okay, so I mirrored it, okay? Do you see the similarities in these patterns? I'm gonna shrink it down a bit. Do you see the similarity? It's basically the same pattern. Do you see it, guys? Do you see the similarity? In a smaller pattern and a bigger one, they're simply just the same construction. They may vary slightly in terms of how it was constructed, but it's the same geometric shape, okay? The only difference here is that this internal wave was a little bit different. As you can see here, it was a little bit different. It was more of a zigzag type wave. Whereas this bigger pattern's B wave was a flat pattern, okay? So we have a B wave as a flat pattern in this example, and in the smaller one, you have a zigzag as the B wave, okay? In both situations, the overall three-wave move, the C wave was truncated. So this C wave was truncated, meaning it was a short wave, and the bigger pattern, the C wave, was also truncated, meaning it's also a short wave. Okay? So we need to understand that in the market, patterns are fractal. The market itself is fractal. It's simple patterns repeating themselves over and over again with slight variations. But if you understand how to identify them, you will realize that you're simply looking for the same things over and over and over again. So whenever you see these patterns, you will understand what they mean, okay? All right, so let's take these off. I think I made my point. Okay, let's look into the chart. Let's see if we can find any other. Okay, I'll leave that big one on. Take off the small ones. All right. So this is our three-wave correction on the higher degree. Okay. And this is, we can consider this to be a WXY, or we could consider this to be ABC. Okay. This is a pattern that I would look at and label as WXY. Okay. Now, after this correction, what can we expect? We can expect that the price will continue in the direction of the trend. And as you can see, this is the direction of the trend, and price continues in the direction of the trend. This pattern is a corrective formation. And once you see these types of corrective formations, you can expect the price to continue in the direction of the trend. All right, let's go ahead. Let's see if we can find ourselves another flat pattern. Can anyone see a flat pattern? Anyone? Can anyone see a flat pattern? Let me know if you see one. I see Patrick says yes. I see Kimberly says yes. Can one of you tell me around what date you think this flat pattern started? Anyone? Okay, I see Kimberly says 20. Okay, yes. So I think Kimberly would have gotten this one right. So here we have, I'm drawing this horizontal line because remember I'm looking for a flat pattern and I want to know if the flat pattern breaks the high. So I need to identify the high. The price was trending up. This was the trend. This is the strong move to the upside. And now I'm getting the pullback, right? So once I'm getting the first wave as my pullback, I will mark my high by drawing a horizontal line. So after I draw my horizontal line, the price comes down, it bounces, it starts to go back to the upside. I will mark my low. Simply copy the line and bring it down to the bottom. Now, this is what I'm looking at. I'm looking at a flat pattern. Can someone tell me what kind of flat pattern I'm looking at? What kind of flat pattern am I looking at? Anyone? And what I'll do here is I will take this one, put it down here, and I will take this one, put it next to it. So this one is bullish and this one is bearish. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip this one. So they both look bullish. Do you see the similarity? Do you see the similarity? All right. I see Patrick says, yes, I see it. Okay, wonderful. So I'll take these off now. Good. So here you can see the price is trending up. You have a three-wave pullback. It creates a low. You have a three-wave move up. And let me just outline this for you. If I'm going to look at this, we have a pullback here. This is my correction. We have a push up. This is my B wave. We have a push down. This is my C wave. In this case, if I'm to mark this, I would mark it like this. Right? Do you see this is also a flat pattern? Can someone tell me what type of flat pattern this is? What type of flat pattern are we looking at here? I'm using the orange arrow to point it out. Kimberly says expanded. Does anyone else agree? I see Kevin says expanding flat. He's not sure. No problem. No problem. By the end, you will be sure. Patrick says expanded. Anyone else? Any other takers? All right. So this is indeed an expanded flat. Can Kevin, can you tell me why you thought this was an expanding flat or expanded flat? Just giving Kevin a chance to let me know what his thoughts are. Kevin says, wave B was higher. Okay, wave B was higher. That's one reason to think that this could be an expanded flat. We have wave B higher than the high that was created. Then we have wave C lower than wave A's low. Okay. So Kevin says, and C was also lower. So that's good, Kevin. Very good observation. So you are correct. All of you are correct when you say expanded flat. Okay? This is indeed an expanded flat. And what happens after these flats complete? Can someone tell me? What happens when these flat patterns complete? We get a move in the direction of the trend. So if you saw this strong move to the upside and you get a flat, what are you going to expect? Can someone tell me? I see Kevin says breakout on the same direction. Okay, you're going to expect a breakout in the direction of the impulse, right? Or we could consider this to be a direction of the trend. This would be a short-term trend, right? So after we get a flat pattern correction, we're going to expect whatever came before the flat to repeat itself. Okay, so if a strong move came before the flat, I'm going to expect that move to repeat itself. And how do I project that? I simply would measure the previous move and I would project that distance when the flat completes itself, like this. As you can see, I get a measured move. I call this market geometry. Okay, this is where I look for measured moves. All right. Now, we understand that we can have a short wave in a three-wave move, but generally we will get measured moves, all right? And this is indeed a measured move. So this is a lovely, lovely three-wave corrector formation. Now, let me just take this off. So we've identified this as an expanded flat, and this bigger move here, I'll label it A, B, and C. I'll change the color, let's put it in yellow. We have identified this as a running flat. Am I correct? This is indeed a running flat, right, guys? You guys with me? Okay, I see Kevin says yes, Kimberly says yes, Patrick says yes, wonderful. So this is a running flat formation. Now, guys, one of the secrets is to first be able to identify a impulse wave or a corrective impulsive wave. to simplify it, just look for a strong move in the market. Once you see a strong move in the market, expect what's going to come after to be a corrective move, a correction of that strong wave. Okay? When you're getting a correction, expect it to come in three waves, not one. So you get one, two, three. That is a full correction. Now you can go long at the end of that correction. If you're going long and it goes one, two, three, you should be looking to exit your trade. Okay? Exit your trade because after three waves, you're either going to get a complete pullback to the bottom or you're going to get a correction for more upside, which would make this an impulsive wave to the upside. So if you got this as an impulsive wave, when the impulsive wave is done, you're going to look for a correction to buy again. Okay? So in this case, you can see we have our one, two, three wave correction. We got one, two, three waves up again. So this is now our B wave or our X wave. And when we refer to it as an X wave could also be considered a failed impulse because this is a full correction. If I'm to label it for you, this would be a full three wave correction. Put it in blue, right? So this would have been a full three wave correction. So this impulsive wave could have repeated itself right here. But because it did not, and it made a three wave move, we can look at this as a B wave. So this entire three wave move will be considered a B wave. Remember, the B wave consists of a three wave move. Okay? In some cases, the B wave could be a triangle, all right? Or in some cases, the B wave could also be a diagonal. So here you can see that we have this three wave B wave. So what are we going to expect? We're going to expect another move to the downside. And as you can see here, this move comes down as a strong wave that looks more like a impulsive move. Okay, so we get this strong impulsive move to the downside. And a lot of times, traders may get confused with this strong wave and they may think that the price is about to melt and continue going down, but it just does not. Because if you understand the flat pattern concept, you will know that whenever the price comes back and approaches these lows, that is the point where you need to exit your trade. So if you took a sell from here, you're looking to exit down here. Okay? For whatever reason you got into this sell, you're going to look to exit here. When you exit here, you're going to look to go long from here to the upside to complete this wave. And just to show you guys, if we use market geometry to help us project our targets, look at this. Pretty close, isn't it? Pretty close. Right? Pretty close. Very close to getting a measured move. So we know exactly, okay, somewhere close to this end of this wave is where we're looking to get out of the market. So we don't get caught in the pullback. All right. Wonderful, wonderful. Okay. So let's see if we can find another flat formation. Can anyone see another flat formation? Let me see if I can help you guys out. If I'm to draw a line in here, look at this as a high. I'm going to draw another horizontal line on the bottom, like this. Right? So this is a little bit more complex. We can look at this one here as our A wave. And then we get 1, 2, 3. So this would be our B wave, and this would be our C wave. The C wave is also 3 waves, okay? So what type of flat would you consider this to be? Just moving the drawing away from the price. You guys tell me what you think it is. Kimberly says running. Anyone else? I see Kevin says expanded flat. Okay, Patrick says running flat. Good observations, everyone. And once it's a flat that you identify, that is the most important part, okay? Once you can identify a flat, this is a, it could be considered a expanded flat because you have it breaking the low and you also have it breaking the high. It could also be considered a running flat if you looked at it like this, with this being 1, 2, and 3. Okay, with this being one wave, this would be the low, this would be the high, so it breaks the high and it comes back and breaks the low over here, so it's still an expanded flat formation. Okay. Good. So it's an expanded flat formation because we have price breaking the low. If this was looked at in this way, where we have this being one wave and this being 1, 2, 3, and this being our next 3-wave move, we could look at the internal wave like this. 1, 2, and 3. Let me just change the color. Good. So that internal wave itself could have been a flat pattern formation as well, and it would have been a expanded flat formation. Okay? If you simply take these two out, take this out, and you take this and put it next to it, you can see that it's pretty much the same thing. Okay? If I put my lines on it, you can see here. Right? Okay, my lines on it. Good. So you can see here that they are both expanded flat formations. This one came from here. This was the one that was telling us that the price was going to go down again, because we have this being the trend. This is the impulse. We get 1, 2, 3. So another push to the downside is expected because the price moves in 3 waves. Remember, the market is fractal and market consists of lower and higher degree pattern formations. So this B wave would be considered a lower degree pattern formation, whilst this one would be considered a higher degree pattern formation. Okay? Everyone clear so far? Let me know in the chat box if you have any questions, if there's anything that you're not too clear on. All right, Kevin says clear so far. Okay. Let's see here. Here we're looking at some more corrective price action. What are we looking at? We can see here the price is kind of overlapping itself. Okay, I see Kimberly's asking, do you always look at 1 hour time frame? It doesn't matter what time frame you look at, you will see the same thing. You will see the same. Would you like us to go to a different time frame? Let's go to a different time frame. Let's just take these off. Let's just erase these. Let's take these off. What time frame would you like us to go to, Kimberly? Kimberly says, do you always look at 1 hour time frame? Would you like me? Okay, she'd like me to look at the 4 hour time frame. No problem. Okay. So we're looking at the 4 hour time frame. Now, we need to understand that certain time frames will give us a better look at price. The 4 hour time frame gives us a good look at what price is. Okay, so it gives us a good look at price. So let's look at this. So I can already identify my flat pattern formations. Can anyone else identify any flat pattern formations here? On the 4 hour time frame, these would be higher degree price action formations. So we're looking at higher degree pattern formations because we're now on the 4 hour time frame. So the candles are looking more defined. You get bigger bars. You can see the stronger moves. Everything becomes a bit more clear. All right. So Kevin says there are three after each impulse. Okay. So this, I'll use the line instead. So if you look at this, we can simply see this is a correction right away. This is a flat pattern formation, expanded flat pattern. This one over here. Just drawing the lines in to show you. This is a running flat formation. This one over here. This is a regular flat formation. And how do I know that this is a regular flat formation? Can someone tell me why I think this is a regular flat formation? Okay, Patrick, go ahead. Why do I think this is a regular flat formation? Just giving Patrick a few seconds to type up his comment. Patrick says, because it didn't make a new high or a new low. All right. So one of the keys that we need to look at is we can look for the B wave. The B wave is very important, or the X wave. So this is 1, 2, 3, right? So this is the B wave. So all I'm looking for is what happened around it. So I have impulse. I got my B wave. I got impulse. So this would be A. This is B. This is C. We change the color that way for you, as you can see here. And this makes it a regular flat formation because we do not break the high and we do not break the low. What happens afterwards? The price continues to the upside. So if we can understand that whenever you get an impulse, you're going to get a correction. And the correction in most cases is going to be a flat pattern formation. Why? Because the flat pattern formation is very, very common. It is one of the most common pattern formations in the market on any instrument. All right, so I'll leave you guys with this for this evening, okay? I won't keep you guys too long. I'll leave you guys with this for this evening. But before I leave, I'll give you guys a chance to ask any questions you'd like. Is there anything that you're not too clear on? Is there anything that you'd like some clarification on? I see Kevin says, great session, thanks. You're most welcome, Kevin. Thank you so much. I appreciate. Patrick says, thank you. I have learned a great deal. You're most welcome. Most welcome, Patrick. Thank you very much. All right. So, I see Kimberly says, I love this class. Thank you so much. You're most welcome, Kimberly. It's my pleasure having you guys here. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for having me. Once again, my name is Leroy Phillips. It was a pleasure being with you. Have yourselves a wonderful evening. I will see you guys on our next class. Bye-bye for now.